I knew who Black Lightning was, and I knew that he was obscure, so that's why I picked him. This is before the CW went into production. We just came out of a feature film that we were working on together, James and I, and we wanted to know what was going to be next. And so I said, man, listen, you know, comic books are hot right now. Why don't we find a character that we can cast all of the actors from the studio to be a part of it, the Breaking Through Acting Workshop, and we came up with Black Lightning.
Oh, that's fantastic, fantastic. Growing up on Static Shock, I was like totally waiting for Virgil. I was kind of disappointed with that. But just having it in that exact world, I was just, how many of your cast and crew actually knew about it already?
Cast and crew knew about it once we had our first table read. Virgil wasn't actually gonna be in the movie, but then when me and Choice were going over the characters, we were like, well, why not throw Virgil in there? They're both, you know, they're both electric superheroes, you know. Black Lightning mentored Virgil at one point.
Yeah.
So we were like, oh, let's just throw him in there. And everybody knew what was going on with the first table read. I wrote the first two drafts. Choice coached me through it. And then he came up with the third and final draft, because my first draft, this would have been a feature film, you know, as long as it was. But yeah,
that's pretty much that. That's wonderful.
We picked Virgil because we knew that a lot of people would confuse Black Lightning. They didn't know Black Lightning, but a lot of kids and a lot of people knew who Static was. So that's what happened with the CW. Like, when he came out, everybody was like, oh, Static is got a show now, and they thought Black Lightning was Static. So that was something that we used as a marketing point, but also to distinguish between the two.
Oh, that's fantastic, fantastic. The costumes you guys actually used for this production, like, how much of it was actually done, you know, in-house?
Man, this guy right here, I'm gonna give James pretty much the credit, although a lot of the actors who were here, they all did their own costumes pretty much. Like, they all went out and got their own outfits and stuff. Austin ordered his pants, the first pair he wanted to get them. I mean,
first, yeah. The first pair of leather pants.
Yeah. 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 Over to Nicholas, so, who played Tech N9ne. So we all worked together. Sachiko was really good at finding what she needed for Lady Shiva, because the Lady Shiva character is not known. So I wanted, you know, a strong Asian representation. That was important to me, that we cast diversity. And so we specifically wanted Lady Shiva rather than the other characters that they've used in the CW world. We wanted, no one knew who Lady Shiva was, and she could beat Batman. Batman couldn't defeat her. She's the only person that, you know, Batman couldn't defeat. So when it came to wardrobe, like my outfit, originally we had someone create something, and it was horrible, and I spent a lot of money on it. But James, in his wisdom, was able to take it and then make what you saw,
wow.
Which, you know, we've been blessed to where people have side-by-side comparisons. They like that outfit the most. It's crazy.
Wow.
So kudos to everybody who, we had a couple of wardrobe things, you know, and seeing someone like Jonesy who went in 100%. Went in, man. He went in, he ordered everything. He took it serious. They all did. Everyone took it serious, so we were able to find some amazing costumes. But James was the one that was like, yo, had me this way. Especially Static.
I'd like to say one thing about that.
Shout out to Mom, John Mother. Because in the middle of shooting all the fight scenes, I had glued on Choice's jacket, the little lighting symbols,
yeah,
and it kept coming off, kept sweating them out, because he was getting behind the camera, then when he was in the shot, he was in front of the camera, he was just moving, and he just kept sweating it out, just kept on, gluing it back on, and Mom saved the jacket by getting it sewed on there, so,
nice.
Thank you, Mom.
Just a joke about the leather pants, so a lot of the things that we were asked to order, it was kind of like, are you sure? But a lot of us had faith in the project and seeing the end result. But initially, you're like, what? So the whole thing was pretty fun from the beginning to the end.
How was choreographing with your costumes. I know it's always hard to have mobility and fashion actually work together.
Well, I have a previous experience. I studied under Art Camacho, who was just a beast of a stunt coordinator, and director, and a fight coordinator. And for me, it's always safety first. And with the first outfit that I had, there was no way it would last shooting, especially through choreography. funny story, Austin, James, and Jay, who is not here tonight, but these guys were throwing themselves, literally, like, and I'm just like filming and watching all the shots, and they're throwing themselves on the ground, and I mean, just getting all in it. The choreography was just something that I was like, it couldn't be like the rain, but it couldn't be dry or dull. It had to fit what's happening. And then with Sachiko being a stunt player, like some of these guys are stunt players, but some of them aren't. Some of them never have done any choreography in their life. Sachiko with the sword, it was just easy. And James, it was easy to play static. He already knew what he wanted to do. But a lot of times it was like we'd be in the park and everybody would have to rehearse on their own, and they'd show up and people would be like wanting to have an idea. You have to be careful because then the ideas start going left and right. And it was just funny that, cause just choreography wise, I always say that Jonesy and Sachiko, they worked the hardest because they just got together and rehearsed. But James, Jay, and Austin were the nuttiest to throw themselves. I mean, that fight scene was intense. It was harder than me and Dimitri. But Dimitri and I, the funny thing is Dimitri, he's got the pain on, so that's an issue. And I couldn't really move. I never really tested the motorcycle jacket that he created. So I was in pain. I had a back brace for 2 weeks afterwards.
Ooh, wow. So the guy that played the mayor, how long were you on your knees?
I'm not going to answer that question. Day, shoot. Yeah. But yeah, we need to have it. It's nice.
Okay.
So a little pad on the ground.
Well, was this just like all that blood splatter on you? Was there any like, you know, any technical difficulties when it came down to it?
Yeah. I actually made a little blood splatter device thing that you pump up with a bicycle pump, and then you release the valve and it's supposed to spray out whatever. You do that? And the first time we did it, it just sprayed all over my face and it didn't look like it came from her, so. Oh well. And the blood on me, though. It looked cool. It was bloody.
What was the country
name? The color of the shirt.
okay, so when it first went on, the blood was like bright red, it looked like blood. And then by the end of it, I think I had to use another shirt because it had dried and it looked like Kool-Aid. It totally looked fake, so yeah. It happens.
We learn. Well, I'd like to open up questions to the crowd.
How long did it take just to choreograph just that last fight sequence, and how long did it take to shoot? I've never looked at anything like that.
Yeah, we were blessed. You know, Chase is an amazing DP. He studied with me to learn how to do what he does. And he's just taken it to another level. So I had him, and I had another DP, Champ Robinson. And it was brutal because, you know, I tend to, when I pick up the camera, I know exactly what I want. And it's a funny story with these guys. We were running out of time. We didn't have any time. We had got this warehouse and we didn't know how much time we were gonna have. And it was like 2 hours, I think, right? 2 hours left. And so I'm like, all right, give me the camera. And I take the camera, Chase is on the camera. I take the camera from Champ. And I'm like, all right, go do this, but got moving on. And the looks on James's, Austin's and Jay's face, like, got it? I'm like, yeah, I got it. And so it was a thing of, because I edit, I knew, and I've been watching fight scenes for so many years of my life, I knew exactly what would sell it. As long as I didn't cross the line, I knew I'd be okay, but I know sometimes people do it purposely, but I just knew I just had to get coverage. So that fight scene of these guys was 2 hours. The fight scene with Dimitri and I, because we stole the location, we were in a parking garage, and we shot it maybe, what, an hour and a half?
It was fast.
So, the makeup, there was no continuity. It's like, you can't do it. You don't have the money, you don't have the time. Sachiko and Jonesy's fight was done 3 hours. It was relaxed. It was a little more relaxed because it was a sword. And I mean, even though we had a fake sword and we had a long one, I didn't want anything to happen to it. Jay and Jesse's scene with the guns, what, an hour and a half? We covered it. We had some overhead shots that I didn't use because it just didn't turn out right. But yeah, it was, that was funny. Jay getting frustrated. Jesse's never had any fight training. Like, some of these guys have never ever thrown a punch at somebody except in the fight. So, yeah. We practiced in the park a lot, as much as we could. I mean, a lot of these guys are working actors, and so they just didn't have the time to meet up. And, you know, you want it to be elaborate, like you want to have wire work and stuff like that. You don't have the money, you don't have the team, you don't have it. And so it's like, well, how do you sell a fight scene and make it look dynamic? This guy here did all the VFX, pretty much. But it looks like it looks because of this one here. He's a brilliant technician when it comes to that.